This is part seven, forgot to put the seven here, of solving rational equations, and we're just working on proportions. So remember, a rational equation that is a proportion has the form a over b equals c over d. So what you have is one fraction equaling another fraction, and the denominators cannot be zero, so neither b nor d can be zero. And we found out when you multiply both sides by bd, which was the least common denominator, you get this equation AD, A times D equals BC equals B times C, so that you get an equation without fractions. So basically, you're multiplying the numerator of one times the denominator of the other. A times D equals B times C. Right, here's one for you to try. So put the video on pause and see if you could solve this one on your own first. All right, it's a proportion, so we could multiply the x minus 6 times the 5, so 5 times x minus 6, and then we could multiply the 3 times the x. Okay, so we've got 5x minus 30 equals 3x, and we could subtract 3x from both sides, and let's add 30 to both sides. So we have 2x equals 30. And if we divide both sides by 2, we get x equals 15. And if that checks, the answer then is 15. Right, so let's check to see if 15 works. Put in 15 for x. So we have 9 thirds, which is 3, 15 fifths, which is 3, so it checks. That was the check. So, yes, our solution is 15. All right, this is another rational equation. We're trying to solve it. It's not a proportion, so you cannot use proportions to solve this in this form. You could multiply both sides of the equation by the least common denominator of x plus 2, or you can make it so that all the denominators are x plus 2 and then make the numerators equal. But as it stands, it's not a proportion. You can, however, alter this slightly if you want to make it look like a proportion because you see that you've got two terms that have the same denominator. And so one way of doing that is subtract 2x over x plus 2 from both sides of the equation. So if I did that, I would have the negative 5 on the left side of the equation, and on the right side of the equation, 7x over x plus 2 minus 2x over x plus 2 is negative 5 equals 5x over x plus 2. This still doesn't look exactly like a proportion, but when you have a whole, actually an integer on one side, so no fraction, you could just put it over 1. So if I want, I could write negative 5 over 1 equals 5x over x plus 2 if you want. So you can take a problem that's not a proportion and sometimes alter it slightly so that you could use the cross products. The cross products is the negative 5 times x plus 2 and the 1 times 5x. So often those are called cross products. You're multiplying these together and then you're multiplying those together and making it equal. So you can't use this until you get it in this form. All right, so let's see. How would we solve this once we have it in this form if I want to use cross products? Well, I could do negative 5 times x plus 2, or I could do 5x times 1 first, doesn't matter. Let's go ahead and just do the 5x times 1. So 5x times 1 is equal to negative 5 times x plus 2. And now we get an equation without fractions, which isn't so bad to solve. So we're going to add 5x to both sides. And then we'll divide both sides by 10. And you can get your solution. So this is just an alternate way to get the solution. And of course, you would have to check negative 1 in the original. So if you're going to check x equals negative 1 in this original, you would write down the equation, plug in negative 1 for x, and now we have to simplify each side. So on the left-hand side, I have to do 2 times negative 1. That's a negative 2 in the numerator, and negative 1 plus 2 is 1 minus 5. And then I need to simplify. Negative 2 divided by 1 is negative 2 minus 5 is negative 7. So the left side simplifies to negative 7. The right-hand side, the numerator, 7 times negative 1 is negative 7. Negative 1 plus 2 is 1. And negative 7 divided by 1 is also negative 7. So it does check so that our solution is negative 1. All right, here's another rational equation, but it also happens to be a proportion. So again, you can use proportions to solve this if you'd like, which means you would multiply x times x plus 5 is equal to x plus 12 times 1. So put the video on pause and see if you could solve this using proportions. All right, let's do it. X times x plus 5 equals x plus 12 times 1. Well, that'll just be x plus 12. Now, when you simplify the left-hand side and the right-hand side, you notice you've got an x squared term, so this is going to be a quadratic. So to solve quadratics, do you remember what you do? You set the equation equal to 0. So I need to subtract x from both sides. That'll be plus 4x and minus 12 equals 0. I think I did this one on a different video using the other method, not using proportions. Right, so we have to factor. You could do that on scratch paper. X plus 6 times x minus 2, and you set each factor equal to 0. So there's going to be two possible solutions here if we did it correctly. Now, keep in mind you can never have a zero in the denominator. So look up to the original problem. I forgot to do this. If I look at the denominator, x plus 12 can't be 0. So that means x can't be negative 12, and it means x can't be negative 5, and well, I didn't get negative 12 or negative 5. So as long as I did all of my algebra correctly, these should be the correct solutions. The only way to tell for sure is to check one at a time. So you'd first take the original equation, plug in negative 6 for x, and make sure you get a true equation. And then you would start over, take the original equation, plug in 2, and see if you get a true equation. And they do both check in this case, but for practice, you should go ahead and try that on your own. On another video, we actually did the same problem using another method, and this is how we checked both of them, so you can see the steps if you were going to check it. So both of them checked, and that's why the solutions really were negative 6 and 2.